video, I'm going to teach you how you can make your website responsive a little bit advanced. So in terms of typography, section, we want it to be responsive in all of the devices and not just for the tablet or like general or common devices for the desktop, tablet and mobile, but we want it to be really responsive in all kind of devices. So we have like for the tablet, we have iPhone, we have Galaxy Fold, we have from the largest to the smallest devices, okay? So the old way is using the rim and viewport, and if you are using a DV, I believe there is a settings in the page builder where you can set up the like the sizes for the desktop and the tablet and the mobile. But it doesn't really target the whole device. It only targets the common sizes of like of the device. So in this video, we will add some extra code or some extra effort to make our website responsive in all of the mobile devices. And this this thing or this CSS that I'm gonna show with you is called Clump. So if you are interested in that, let's begin now. 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna show with you my process and how I make the typography responsive as possible in all WordPress website. So regardless if you are using a DV or WordPress, this will definitely work. But as I said, I'm gonna use DV as an example. By default, you have an option in DV to put or to set a value for the desktop, for the tablet, and for the mobile, okay? So, but the problem that I am kind of concerned in this part is I believe they only have one set dimension for the desktop and for the tablet and for the mobile devices. And like, there's a lot of mobile devices with different dimension or with different width. So that is something I'm kind of worried of. That's why I use media query for this, in case the font size is getting off. Now, instead of putting inline or instead of declaring style in the design tab options, I really recommend you to set up a global value for on your styles.css, because that will save you a bits of storage or paint into your lighthouse, okay? And I believe that's actually the reason why the DV is a bit longer to load, because this one is super friendly, but in terms of making your code dry, when you say code dry, it means do not repeat yourself. So in terms of making your code dry, it's not really possible, because it is generating a redundant value if you use the design tab. Okay, I know like front-end developer can understand what I'm trying to say in here, but yeah, as much as possible, if you can set up a global value, if the value is repetitive, then you shouldn't be using the design tab. So one of the example of the repetitive values are the headings, okay, the h1s, the p thing, okay. So okay, so this is okay, heading 3, actually want to use h2 for this. So H2, and let's dive into the H2 part in here. So I don't want to put any value there, okay? So I will not put any value for this style thing, because I want to keep all the repetitive elements, let's say heading and text, dry, okay? When you say dry, do not repeat yourself. It shouldn't be redundant, okay? So, okay, so we have that. So what I said in here, and the theme options is H2 has a fallback of 1.93 rem. So I already convert this one. So basically this 1.93 is equivalent to 31.98 pixel, okay? But I did not set a pixel for this, because pixel is a static image, okay? A static unit value, and I want to adjust the font size according to the dimension or the resolution of the browser, okay? This one is a fallback because the clump thing is not supported in all of the browsers, but it is supported in most of the browsers. If we go into the clump browser support, okay? So we have this one, okay? So these are supported by clump, but other browsers like Edge 11, 610, this part in here doesn't support a clump CSS. That's why we need to come up with a fallback. And I set a fallback value to rem instead of pixel because I want to adjust the font size according to the dimension. So we still want the font size responsive. Other way around of doing this is using the media query, but as I said, I want to keep the CSS cleaner as possible, optimized as possible if it can be optimized. So that's why I use this clump thing versus on using media query. Other, I think before I am also using calc, but I set some media query on it, and I just find that this is cleaner versus on the calc thing. So we have a fallback, and then we have a font size of clump 22 pixel, and this one is a default value. This will be the maximum font size, and this one will be the minimum font size. And I also did similar for the line height. So this value is the one that I set on the FEMA. By the way, if you want to learn more how you can come up with a typography guideline, this part, I highly recommend that you check my other video for more information. So I set up something in here. So what will happen, okay, so if we refresh that, so what will happen is if I inspect the elements, by the way, I am using Galaxy Fold. This is the smallest version of smartphone. So we want to make it, we want to know how it looks on mobile devices, on smaller mobile devices. So this is how it looks in smaller mobile devices. And if you go into the iPhone Pixel, I mean, this is perfectly good. Yeah, so other thing. Yeah, so this is super perfect. So basically, it is 32 pixel for those. I mean, this one will not go further. The H2 will not go further to 31 pixel or 32 pixel, regardless of how big the browser is. So if you come up like 2200 pixel browser, if I just check this one, it should be still 32 pixel. Okay, 32 pixel with a line height of 45px. And also for, let's say, mobile devices, so still the same. The font size should be still, okay, let's check the browser again. So the minimum font size would be 23 pixel. So this is something we have set it in here, 23 pixel or 22.62. It rounded to 23 pixel because we have a 5 viewport. Okay, so that's basically it. I'm done.